All right, so I played another one of these WSOP legacy things, and we had a pretty deep run, but what I'd like to do here is sort of go over some of these hands, some of the meatier ones, and we're gonna do it in like stages. You're gonna have early, middle, and late. So in this video, you're gonna see some of the early stage, deeper stack plays, and hands and stuff like that, and yeah, so enjoy that.
Today we're gonna play some 6-max, because 6-max is fun. 6-max, you really get to just do a lot more shenanigans, right? You're gonna be playing a lot more hands. Push the envelope. We're going to talk some 6-max shenanigan strategy. So what do we got? Two rebuys allowed. What is it buying? $320? A couple of five. 6-max. We got a raise. Holy shit. What kind of raise is this? What the hell? That's a very big raise. And a call. All right. Let's freaking flop a set. That's some weird-ass open there, bud. Weird-ass open there, bud. Probably too big of a raise to call pre-flop with the fives, shorthanded. Could have just folded that, but I don't mind gambling when we're this deep a little early on. All right, ace flop, back doors. He's making it expensive, so I'll just fold. All right, what do we got? Ace king here. I'm gonna check this one. Sometimes I bet, sometimes I check. This time I'm gonna check. I'm not folding, right? He could easily have a six or a seven, but he also has draws. So we're not going to fold. Going to definitely call the turn. That's a bad card for us, because now if he had 8-9, 8-5, 8-10, he beat us. He might have a deuce, but we have a good enough showdown hand, so I'm just going to check. And he has king 4 hearts. Okay, sweet. So he had the heart draw. Decided not to bluff at that card. I think he's supposed to bluff at that card. Maybe not with his hand, but right? Like the 9 seems to hit him. All right, queen 9 of diamonds. We have one limper here. All right, I'll limp along with you if you want to play a little limpy-dimpy. A little limpy-limpy game, six-handed. Limpy-dimpy, six-handed, why not? I could raise this hand too. Guy limps under the gun, so we're going to give it a little bit of respect. Okay, now we got a pretty sizable raise from the button, a call. I mean, if it's a multi-way pot, we can gamble. Microphone right here. All right, everybody's in. So am I. Okay, we got middle pair, gut shot, but that's a really what we call wet board. There's no backdoor diamonds, which would be nice. So there's not a lot of great cards for us, right? He leads in with a quarter pot. We got the razor behind us. I could just call, which is the normal play, but this guy's not bluffing, right? And then I got the player behind me who might raise another player, so let's just get out of the way right now. Right? Because that's a trouble hand. Middle pair, great. Overcard, nice. Gut shot straight, nice. But, like, we could be dead already. Okay, now we got queens and nines. Congrats, right? But, like, we can't go crazy because he could have a jack. He could have a straight. He could have two pair. He could have, you know, two better pairs like queens and tens or sets. And oh, wow. We got a check raise there. And a seven on the river. So, I mean, look. Well, what the heck did we have? Two pair, and one single jack makes a straight. Obviously, this guy T-Money has at least... Oh, really? He's checking. He has a jack. Okay. And what did this other guy bet on the turn with? Let's see what he led with. He had king-queen. Interesting. Not good at all. That play by... I'm going to make a note. All right. We're going to make a little note. Sorry, dude. You got the fish. I put that down as fish play. King-jack. I am going to 3-bet this one to 720. Sometimes you 3-bet, sometimes you flat. I choose to randomize a little bit in these spots, and this is a hand that I'm going to do that with based on this specific combo. All right, and we pick it up. Got you good. Let's go 900. Sort of. Okay, let's get back to the hand. Got kings. Making it 9x, I've been called. All right. The other player doesn't have aces ever, so let's just let him in. Let him in. If he has an ace, so be it. Ace flops, we're dead. What are you going to do? Try to milk it, get max value for the kings. It's not every day you pick up a pair of kings when you get them. You got to make some money with them. So I don't care what he does. If he decides to go all in, great. We just call it off. He does have a big stack compared to everybody else. All right, he did call. So in this spot, generally with this stack size, I'm gonna bet quarter pot, like 2,000. Or he goes all in. I'll just call. He has jacks. Okay, and king nine. That's a pretty good spot for old D-Nakes to just wham bam, you know, triple up all that stuff. So that guy didn't move in with jacks. That's interesting. So he was waiting for a favorable flop. All right. So he made it two. We're gonna go 1150. You want your raise sizes out of position to be bigger than when in position, okay? You're going to raise more often in position. So this is a flop we can check or bet. In this case, I'm going to elect to check and call. Sometimes bet, sometimes check. I'm going to check this time. Certainly not going to fold there. Hoping for a jack. That's a flop that really smashes his range, unfortunately. Like a lot of hands that he would call with have a pair now. But at that price, I have to call. Take one off. Hope for the jack. Ace, king could be good. All right, there's the jack. And now the question is, do I lead? Nah, I don't think leading makes sense. Hopefully he has a nine and we get it all. I think check here. And if he bets, there's a decent chance he has a nine and maybe we could get it in now. Well, he's betting 3,000, so he's got seven left. He's not bluffing. Just want to make sure I get the other 7,000 in. I'm trying to figure out the best way to do that. I think just call. I think if he has a 9, he's going to jam it anyway. And if he's bluffing, we give him full rope, right? There was no flush draw on the board either. Okay, so he checked back. What did he have? Let's see. He had pocket jacks. So that was... what a bad bet he made. All right. I guess in hindsight, right, I could have just stuck it in on the turn. And won the rest of the 7,000. But unfortunately, I chose to slow play it, which, I mean, it's fine, but it's unfortunate. Like, he's really not supposed to bet that hand. You know what I mean? Like, he's just not supposed to have a hand like three jacks or two pair that can call. He's supposed to check that hand on the turn most of the time. His hands that bet the turn should be a nine. Gonna just flat this one. So I didn't have him on sets. Okay, if I thought he had could have a set, then I would obviously just put it in on the turn. But when I check raise the turn, I don't really have a lot of bluffs there, right? I'm just always going to have at least a nine. What am I going to check raise bluff with there? I'm going to check one time. Now we've made a pair. I was going to do a delayed bluff on turn, but now we don't have to because I made a pair. And this is just marginal. So I have showdown value now. I beat some ace high hands and stuff. So I can go ahead and just check that back. Now we got queens and seven. So against a small sizing bet, like if he bets one third pot or half pot, I can just snap it off. If he has a 10 or an eight, so be it. If he has a queen, congrats. If he has better, well, go ahead. Take it. Certainly not folding. All right, 400. Oh, so he's betting two thirds. Now that's an interesting sizing. As played, if he goes check, check, bet. Check, check, bet. Now the question is, would he bet ace high? And if not, what bluffs does he have? King high? Feels very value heavy. What value? I just don't think there's a lot of bluffs here. Ace high turned into a bluff, maybe? All right, whatever. Close one. All right, 6-4 clubs in the small blind. Gonna limp right in there. Pretty much limping our entire range at this stack size. And I have absolutely nothing to do with this board. All right, we have absolutely nothing. So, naturally, what's the minimum bet? Minimum bet's 150? All right, I'll bet it. I was going to bet 120, but I forgot you can't. We have absolutely nothing here. So no showdown value in a spot like that. Total bottom of our range, six high. We're just going to try to steal one, and we do. We are sitting in seventh position out of the entire tournament. Double the average. So far, so good. All right, we're going to go ahead and make this one 500. I like to stick with about 2.5 times the blow. Well, with exactly 2.5 when we're this deep. As we get deeper into the tournament, I will lower it. Jack 9 offsuit, not a great hand. With an ante, it's definitely an open. Without an ante, it's questionable. All right, break time. My ace 4 of clubs, we're going 500. What is this, a 3 bet? Oh, man. It's small enough we can take a flop. It's not our flop. This may be one we have to bluff. So let's go. All right. I have a gut shot. I have like really not a good hand, right? What did I bet? How much did I bet? Quarter. Oh, I bet too little. Damn it. Whatever. That's fine. Actually, it's fine. It's a monotone board. All right. Sweet. We picked it up. Nice. You got to bluff sometimes. Could have been bluffing with the best hand. Probably not. Updates. It's still early. We're fifth place right now. Out of 228 players. Started with 247. And there are rebuys. A little more than a min raise. We're going to defend with the ace. An okay flop. Four into 11. I'm going to check raise this sometimes. I'm just going to call this time. It's a pretty good card for our range when we check all the flop. I'm going to check. This is the guy who folded earlier, right? This wouldn't be a bad spot to check raise the turn, actually. Five on the river. It's a good card for us. This question is, how much do we need to bet to bluff this guy? I think a lot. We're going to bet over pot. We're just hoping to get him to fold like two tens, an ace jack, ace king. He doesn't beat a lot, right? He beats ace deuce, ace three. Ah! Smart. We bluffed that guy twice now. Both times with ace high, though. But again, ask yourself, like, what's the worst hand I can have as played? Deuce three suited? And I can have a lot of really good hands, right? Because a five paired, I have way more fives than he does because he raised under the gun, right? So when you think about that, when someone raised under the gun, they're going to have a smaller range than when someone defends the big blind. My range of hands that would defend the big blind are going to have a five in it a decent amount of time. His won't. So when that five pairs the board, and the board runs out in a three-card straight, it's really hard for him to call. Right? You get it? You get what I'm saying now? So when you think about poker, okay, when you think about cards that come, you should always be thinking about, is that card better for me or better for him in terms of range? Not your actual hand. Like, okay, the five didn't help me, right? I still have the same hand. But the five kind of does help the entire range of hands that I could have. And when that's the case, now you can up your sizing. This is something that Helmuth will not understand. Is there are certain board textures and certain cards that come off that will allow you to bet bigger sizes. And there's other spots that call for smaller sizes. For example, on monotone boards, monotone meaning like three flush boards, typically you want to bet smaller sizing. On disconnected boards, let's say like 10-8 deuce king, that's where you can actually in position bet bigger. Now we got jacks. All right, so this time off of a 7K stack, we're going to go set 9X, about 1836. Okay, we got a gamble here. We got the flip situation. Running hot, y'all. Running hot. Picked up another one. 36K. That's a really, really healthy stack there. Let's see. Puts us in first place. Haha, we are the chip leader. All right. Chip leader is going to raise with the king on the button. We are chip leader, people. Numero uno. Top dog in the tournament as of right now. All right, let's go with 750. What's that? 9,000. So that's 30 big blinds is way too much to call with ace nine suited. If he had, let's say, 15, that would be closer, but not for that many. So there is still another hour and 20 minutes of rebuys available.
We don't.
Gonna raise this time just to 900, push the envelope. I didn't finish high school, Luke Sampson. I did not. Okay. Yeah. We're going to delay this bluff for another card. And that's a good one for us to bluff at. Going to bet half pot when he checks. And here it comes. And we're really just hoping to pick it up here. But we know that we're betting this turn. We're also betting the river. We're not betting this to fold the river. MA says we win it.
Moneymaker.
All right. I'm just going to flat this one. Sometimes three bets, sometimes flat. Okay. Luke Sampson. All right, let's just talk about the hand. All right, so we have nothing on this flop. We got back doors. Got ace high still. We still could easily have the best hand here. And we should bet this some of the time, but we're not going to this time. Now that the turn card is a jack, I think we're still going to... Well, we're going to call this bet. Don't love it, though, because here's the thing, right? He's betting 2,026, so we're risking 2,000 to win 4,700. So we're not getting quite the direct odds with just the flush draw. If our ace is good, maybe we are. Now we're getting a better price. It's 2 to win 6. So we can easily just make this call right now and whiff the river. And I don't think this is a spot where we can really bluff. I don't have a heart in my hand. I have ace high. I mean, there's like a small chance. They both have freaking 9-10 or queen 10 or something. But I don't think this is a good spot to bluff. So I'm going to check. Set of deuces and a flush. Okay then, gentlemen. Yeah. Whee! Right? Dodge that bullet there. 6-5 suited, just gonna call, see a flop. That's a good flop. That's what's known as a straight flush. So we're gonna check the absolute nuts. Oh my goodness. What a weird, that's not a great card for us. I'm gonna check again. Hope he bets. He did bet. All right, I don't think I can raise even. If he has the king of clubs, he's gonna bet himself. He has the queen. He'll probably value bet, so I've got to string him along a little bit more. Just call with the clubs. And the board paired. Let's hope he has a full house. If he has a full house, then he's screwed. If he's got a full house, he is dead. Damn. What did he have? Hard to make money when you have a straight flush and the board comes four clubs. He had ace three. He had an ace and a three, so he turned two pair and bet it. I don't think I could have made much more than that, unfortunately. Pretty good hand though, huh? Straight flush. Yeah. Right on the flop there, eh? We may not agree on very much. Well, hold on. Let me raise this pot. Let's make it 1,000. Thank you. It says, we may not agree on much politically, but you're very intelligent and are an amazing human being and very respectful. If I had to go back and forth with anyone, it would be you. Love the masterclass. Thank you very much, Survival Summit. I think that would be great if the world could get to that place, right? Where it used to be. Right, we disagree, but we do so respectfully. Speaking of respectfully, I'm going to bet 1,000 respectfully. Quarter pot. We got the top pair, the top kicker. We don't always bet this. I bet sometimes. I check sometimes. 9 on the turn. Heart. So I'm going to bet 4,000. It's getting a little... Yeah, squirrely now. Oh, shit. All right. Jack of spades. Wow. Interesting. He called rather fast on the turn. I'm going to check, and I think I'm going to fold to a jam here. That would be crazy, right? But no, this is a good play. It's too wet of a card. I was going to bet a lot of river cards. He had ace queen with the queen of spades. Wow. Good play by him to not go broke there. Bravo. If the river, that's a bad card, right? Now I don't lose. I lose to ace jack. I lose to spades. I lose to any hand that was already two paired. So jamming with ace king there on the river is a little too thin. So I elected to check back. I don't know. He might have folded anyway. Either way, yours truly is sitting second in the whole tournament. I'm folding this 10 deuce. Anegs would make an appearance, but she'd have to do herself up. She's not like a guy like me. She's going to, you know. All right, 7-9 of spades in the big. We are going to call. And we are going to check and call. Almost like this hand, standard check and call, unless he just goes all in or something like that. But even against the pot size bet, we would just call here. You're not going to check raise this hand. This is not a good hand to check raise with. What's the point? Does you no real good. This is the kind of hand that Phil Hellmuth would check raise with. He'd min check raise and then blank check the turn, which is really not good and very easy to exploit. Okay, ace on the turn. Not a great card for us. I'm going to check. Really not a good card for us. If he bets this turn, it's a problem, right? He probably doesn't have a 10 if he bets the turn. He could. But an ace is a very possible card for him to have. He raised on the button. I mean, he could be betting us off with some draws or some gut shots. Okay, that's another not-so-good card. Because now we beat nothing. We beat no hands. So this is just a check fold right here. We beat, like, king five. If he should bluff king five and he's going to win it because there's not enough combos. Two kings. Wow. Okay. So the ace kind of helped us. Very nice. I was folding turn anyway. But nice hand, buddy. Acey Deucey. Acey Deucey in the housey. Yeah. Playing. I'm going to defend this one. Just a check. This is a perfect example of a pure check call. You don't check raise here. That's stupid. You just check call because you want to protect your check call range. And I would check call here with a lot of hands. So ace is going to be one of them. I don't love it if he bets here, right? Because if he bets here, he's saying I can beat ace deuce. Now, do I believe him? Yeah, but I'm not folding yet. Yeah, I think I have to call. Yeah, because I don't block any of his spade draws, straight draws, nothing like that. If you have a calling hand here, you'd rather have ace-deuce than you would, like, ace-five. Like, with a spade. Okay, ace-ten, cool. All right, saved a bet on the river. I had a feeling he had it. I was like, we can't fold the turn. That's a little too premature. That would have been pretty sick if I folded the turn. But the guy bets again. He's saying ace deuce is no good, you know. So the question is, do you buy it? But it's a chance. It definitely won't happen in the summer on the regular, usual time. So this is not a terrible spot to run a squeeze. Puts King James. We're going with King James, but you got to imagine King James range is not that strong, right? So ace 10 should be fine against it. The one we're worried about here is Dusty 4. If Dusty 4 moves in, we fold. If King James moves in, we have to call with our hand. Because we've already put in 4,800. He's only going to... Oh, fuck. Son of a bitch. Bad timing. Okay, well, it was a good spot, but the guy had to have it, you know? He's not going to be bluffing there. I'm just going to flat this one. He's an incredible player. You know, a franchise player. The question is what you're going to have to give up. Probably Lafreniere at least. You know? It's a lot. It's going to be a lot. So I would say wait. Be patient. Maybe when he's a free agent. Or, you know, there'll be other opportunities. For everybody wants to play in New York. So Rangers don't have an issue of, like, finding, you know, free agents that'll come. It's a good flop. My hair is not fake. Totally real. Sorry. How is Lane Flack, asks Nitro nowadays? I don't know. I don't see him much anymore. I don't know. Used to see him on the golf course here and there, but have not in a while. He's betting. This is just a call. Sometimes you can raise, but I'm going to lean towards call. Now that the Rio is sold, where do you think the live World Series will be held? I think it's going to happen at the Rio. I don't know. I haven't heard it moving yet. Raul Torres. Oh, man. He's making a big bet this time. 37 to win. 10. Oh, it's close. This one's close. Outside chance we have the best hand. Well, we do now. This is where we just ship it. Jam it. We got the nuts. I thought about half pot or like something in between. But for him to bet the turn, he should be pretty strong. And he had a straight. Wow. So he turned. He was bluffing too. So my ace high was good. Wow, he makes a straight, and we win ourselves a nice big old pot there. Top 11 stack. Am I into F1? No. Queen 5 suited in position. Again, he's pretty short. Let me see. What is that? 3 and a bit. I think I have to call this anyway. It's a little expensive. Yeah, now we're in. In like Flynn. Beat a lot of hands now. I'm going to check this back. Queens and fives. Good situation right now. All right, what do you got, bud? No good. Oh, baby. Queens and fives. Hell, we got really lucky there. Huh. Very lucky. Lowest golf score playing from the white tees at TPC Summerlin. Shot myself a 79. From the back tees, the blue tees, I shot an 80, which was a big bet. $550,000 bet that I made and I was able to win. All right, so he's short, so we just go all in, right? We're going to go all in with a lot of hands here, which he's supposed to call a lot. Like if he has a king, he's supposed to call, like king three, king deuce. All right, should be a chop. Okay. Yeah, pair of nines, ace, king seven. Chop it up. That's a standard play. You're going to see that in a lot of tournaments by the end. Small blind, big blind confrontations. It's just like, all right, I have to go all in. And the other guy's like, all right, I have to call. It's just that simple. That's another jam. Boom. Automatic. He's got nine bigs or something like that. Yep. Easy peasy. Pick it up. If he calls, so what? We have 9-8 suited. You know? But if he has Jack Deuce, he folds. We pick it up. Royden Vickers. St. Jude's, please up the sensitivity on your voice mic. 5%, 10%. Roll Tide. Roll. I don't know, man. I don't like to fuck with the mic thing because then I screw it up. I'll get closer. Thank you, Richard Walker in the UK. Starts a 12-hour shift at 6, so you better get some sleep, buddy. 6 a.m., that's no joke. All right, what do we got here? Ooh, it's not an ideal situation. The thought is all three. Not going to fold, though. I could just jam now. I think I'm going to wait and see a flop. Not a good flop. We don't beat much now. Don't beat ace-king. I mean, the only hand we beat is ace-queen. Ace-jack, maybe. So I think I saved 16K because I don't think he was folding those. All right, well, he checked, huh? That's interesting that he checked. I'm going to check too. Now we have a spade draw. And a couple of eights. It's an interesting spot. I can call against the very small bet. This is the guy with the 10-jack earlier, right? Yeah, I think he could have like jacks here. Or queens even. Doesn't necessarily have to have a spade. I'm going to check it back again. Now the question is the river. Would he value bet jacks or queens now? Has played, I think so. What bluffs would he have if he bets? All right, well, he's going to have jacks or queens and we're just going to lose. But we got a free ride. I told you. You see how I do it? You see how I do? I saved the 16,000. I didn't bet. Tranquilo. Very nice. We lost the minimum. How long will this tournament last for, asks Mark Stacey. I'm not sure. But the blinds too do start to get up there. And all right, I'm going to take a flyer with the queen nine suited. Not a bad flop. It's going to be a check call. Yeah, you don't really check raise on this board. You know, you didn't 3-bet pre. He has all the aces, kings, queens, at jacks, so his range is better than mine. I'm just going to call. Now we made the flush. I'm going to check once again. Hopefully he has an overpair with a club or something. 6,000, huh? Now the only question is get it in now or try to... Now I think I'm going to wait. Let's hit the time bank. It's an interesting spot. Do I jam now? After all this tanking, I'm just going to call. Now we just check snap call. I'm trying to represent like I have a 10 here. And if he has an overpair, he might value bet it. Like if he has aces, why not? It certainly doesn't look like I have a flush. I'm thinking, okay, let's see. Ah, it worked out. It did work out. So he thought we had a 10. We could have got in on the turn as it played because, you know, he had the club. But it worked. All right, sweet. Making some hands. Let's see here. We've got fifth place. We are fifth out of 164.